हेलो स्टूडेंट्स एंड नमस्ते एवरीवन, आई एम धवल सर एंड अवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज़ योर लिटरेचर पार्ट दैट इज़ फ्रॉम योर फर्स्ट फ्लाइट सेकेंड चैप्टर नेल्सन मंडेला लॉन्ग वॉक टू फ्रीडम. इन अवर फर्स्ट पार्ट वी हैड सीन द इंट्रोडक्शन इन विच वी हैड सीन दैट दिस चैप्टर इज़ एन एक्सट्रैक्ट फ्रॉम नेल्सन मंडेलाज ऑटोबायोग्राफी. ओके, then we had seen that how Nelson Mandela spent 30 years in the jail fighting for his own nation, that is South Africa, to get freedom from the Britishers. And we had seen the apartheid system through which the Britishers tried to create difference between the people of different class, that is the people belonging to white skin and the people belonging to black skin. So South Africa is actually the place which is the inhabitant of black skin people, but then too those people, that is the black skin people, were not given any kind of freedom. So in the first part we had seen that how Nelson Mandela, as well as the pictures you can see on the screen, that is the different freedom fighters, these are the people, right? Oliver Tambo, Walter Sisulu, Bram Fisher, right? So all this, Yusuf Dadu, all this were the freedom fighters of South Africa. They were the people who had fought for their nation and they had sacrificed their life for the country, that is South Africa, right? So the page which you can see on the screen, we had completed the explanation till this page. Now today we'll move further and complete our whole chapter in this second part of the video. Okay, perhaps it requires such depths of operation to create such heights of character. So in the last lecture, that is in the first part of this chapter, we had seen that Nelson Mandela is saying that with the negative things there was something positive also. What was that positive thing which came out from the operation was the people like Yusuf Dadu, Oliver Tambo and many such people who had emerged as a fighter against the Britishers. So he was saying that if such kind of operation, such kind of cruelty was not seen by the people of South Africa, then even they would have never seen such kind of people in their country. Okay, so same thing is repeated over here, that perhaps it requires such depths of operation. We have already seen that is the unjust or cruel behavior, right, of power. If a person is having power, then he uses that power for unjust or cruel behavior towards other people. So such depths of operation to create such heights of character. Such heights of character means, I can give you one example of Gandhiji, right? So when India was also under the British rule, first of all, Gandhiji was not a person whom we all knew, right? But just because of the problems and all the differences what he saw, there was a change in him, there was a character built in him which shook the British Empire in India, and the Britishers were forced to leave India and go back to England. Okay, so that is creation of character. My country is rich in the minerals and the gems that lie beneath its soil. So we know that in South Africa there are diamonds and rubies and everything available from the soil or underneath the ground. Okay, but I have always known that its greatest wealth is its people, finer and truer than the purest diamonds. So here Nelson Mandela is saying that though our soil, that is our country, produces lots of diamonds and everything, but our true diamond is the people of South Africa, who are very honest, who are very true and who are very fine. Okay, it is from this comrades means companions, companion means friends or the people who work together. So it is from this comrades in the struggle that I learned the meaning of courage, Right. So what Nelson Mandela is saying, that I learned the courage from these people. From these people, I learned how to fight against the Britishers and everything. Time and again, I have seen men and women risk and give their life for an idea. I have seen men stand up to attacks and torture without breaking, showing a strength and resilience that defies the imagination. So resilience means the ability to deal with any kind of hardship and recover from its effect, right? So that defies the imagination. So he is saying that whenever in life, if a person has to face any kind of problem, and it is at that time only we can see or we can come to know that such person is so strong, right? So that person who is facing the problem fights against such kind of problems, and he tries to withstand the problems he is facing, and he tries to come out of it. Okay, I learned that courage was not the absence of fear, but the triumph over it. So what Nelson Mandela is trying to say through this, that I learned that courage was not the absence of fear. So if a person is not having any kind of fear of anything, then we cannot say that he is courageous, right? He is saying that the triumph over it. So if the person, triumph means victory. If a person conquers fear, that means he has no kind of fear, then only we can say that he is courageous. Okay? No one is born hating another person because of the color of the skin or his background or his religion. We all know that the children or the child, right, small children are very innocent, right? When they are born, they don't know anything, who is white skin person or who is a black skin person, who is good, who is bad, nothing, right? They treat everyone equal or same. So in the similar fashion or similar way, we all know that when we are born, we don't know the differences of any kind in the society. It is taught to us, right? And when we are taught all these things, then and then only it is the thing which we learn. Before that, we don't know any kind of differences in the society. So what he is saying, that no one is born hating another person because of the color of his skin or his background or his religion. People must learn to hate, and if they can learn to hate, they can be taught to love. So what he is trying to say, that people are taught how to hate the people, right? Negativity is inserted, or negativity is taught to the person. It is not born natural. So Nelson Mandela is trying to say that if a person can be taught negativity, then we can also taught those people how to love, right? We can also spread love equally. If a person is there who is trying to spread negativity, then as a person, if we try to spread love, friendship, happiness, then but obvious that opposite person will also try to learn it. Okay, for love comes more naturally to the human heart than its opposite. Then its opposite means hatred. So it's very easy, right? If we are good to other people and if we do good deeds and good work, then it's but natural that other person will have a feeling of love for us, right? So to bring the feeling of love is more easier than to bring the feeling of hatred. Even in the grimmest times in prison, grimmest means severe, right? So even in the grimmest times in prison, when my comrades and I were pushed to our limits means the last point, right? We all have the capacity to bear something, the pain or the anything or the problems. So what here is saying, pushed to the last point in our ability to bear pain. So what Nelson Mandela is saying, that when my comrades and I were pushed to our limits, I would see a glimmer of humanity in one of the guards. Glimmer means a small amount or sign of something. So here he is saying that when they were beaten up in the jail by the Britishers, then even at that time also Nelson Mandela could find a bit of humanity. That means the person who was beating around him, other people, other officers or the other soldiers or the policemen were also there. In some of them, he could find the humanity. Perhaps just for a second. But it was enough to reassure me and keep me going. That means when he saw even a bit of humanity in that person, it was enough for him. And he again got a lot of confidence every time when he saw a small quantity or even a bit of humanity in that person, because he could understand or he could realize that no, still there is humanity on the earth, and a time will come when there will be change in this people, and everywhere love will be spread and humanity will be seen. Okay, man's goodness is a flame that can be hidden but never extinguished. So through these lines, it is very important line, he is trying to say that if a person is trying to suppress his goodness, if he is trying to hide his goodness, right, then for no longer time, right, it will be hidden. A time will come when it will be out and he will be again good to the other people. That means he is trying to say that never in a person the goodness can be extinguished or it can be totally vanished, right? Due to some or the other circumstances, if the person has faced any problem or anything, then a feeling of hatred might have developed in that person, but still we can say that in that person a time will come when again all the hatred will be forgot and again he will start loving the people. Okay, in life every man has twin obligations. Twin obligations means two obligations, right? Obligation to his family, obligation means we can say the duty, right? So we have our responsibilities and duties towards our family, to his parents, to his wife and children, and he has an obligation to his people, his community, his country. So these are the two different obligations. One is the obligation towards the family and the other is the obligation towards the nation, towards the country and its people. In a civil and human society, each man is able to fulfill those obligations according to his own inclinations. Inclinations means natural tendencies of behavior. So what he is saying, that each person has tendencies, right? So each man is able to fulfill those obligations according to his own inclinations and abilities. But in a country like South Africa, it was almost impossible for a man of my birth and color to fulfill both of these obligations. Right, so what is saying, that if a person is very loyal towards his family, then he will be always loyal towards his family. He will be, means, less diverted towards the country. And we have seen the army soldiers, policemen and many other commandos and everything who are very much loyal towards the country. They are so much devoted towards their country that they give first preference to the country and then they give the importance to their family. Okay. In South Africa, a man of color who attempted to live as a human being was punished and isolated. So, in South Africa, a man who tried to fulfill his duty to his people was inevitably ripped. Inevitably means unavoidably, and ripped means split. That means when a person used to help the people of his own country, that is in South Africa, because in South Africa the Britishers had their rule and the people, that is the black skinned people, were treated like slaves and they were treated very cruelly, right? So if they tried to fight against the Britishers, they were very badly treated and they were put behind the jails and the bars, right? So they could not even try to help their own people or the family members. Okay, so what is given? They were inevitably ripped from his family and his home and was forced to live a life apart. Live a life apart means, as I said, that if a person is trying to help the people of his country, is trying to fight against the Britishers, then they were separated from the family and he was forced to live away. That means in the jail or the other place. A twilight existence of secrecy and rebellion. Twilight means darkness. Existence of secrecy. That means secrecy means secret, and rebellion means if a person, right, is against his own government, then we can say that is his rebellion. Okay, so I have given the meaning also, open opposition towards a person or a group in authority. So again, I'll read the whole line. In South Africa, a man who tried to fulfill his duty to his people was inevitably ripped from his family and his home and was forced to live a life apart, a twilight existence of secrecy and rebellion. That means he was forced to live away from the family, he was tortured a lot, right? And due to that, a feeling of rebellion kind of feeling was generated in them. I did not in the beginning choose to place my people above my family, but in attempting to serve my people, I found that I was preventing from fulfilling my obligations as a son, a brother, a father, and a husband. So what Nelson Mandela is saying, that I did not in the beginning choose to place my people above my family. That means for him, his family was first. In the beginning, when he was not matured enough, when he was still a child, he always gave preference to his family and he did not give importance to the people. People means the people of his own country, right? But in attempting to serve my people means when he was trying to save his family, when he was trying to fulfill his family's needs and everything, he was trying to save his family from the Britishers, he found that he was prevented from fulfilling his obligations as a son, a brother, a father, and a husband. That means he's trying to say that later on, when he realized that his duties are not just towards his family, his father, mother, and sister, and everyone, he realized that his duty is towards the greater society, towards the people of South Africa. Okay? I was not born with a hunger to be free. I was born free. Free in every way that I could know. That means when he was young, he was a child, he did not know that he is not having any kind of freedom. He did not know that he was under the control of the Britishers. He did not know that what the Britishers said, only those things are to be followed and to be done. Right? So he is saying that when he was born, he was totally free and he could do anything he wanted to do. Free to run in the fields near my mother's hut, free to swim in the clear stream, then ran through my village, free to roast millies. Millies means corn, right? We have heard about sweet corn, that is millies. Under the stars and ride the broad backs of slow moving bulls, right? So these are the activities which he used to do when he was a child. There was total freedom. Whatever he wanted to do, he could do whatever he wanted, right? As long as I obeyed my father and abided means that is to accept without objection, without denying anything, abided by the customs of my tribe, I was not troubled by the laws of man or God. It was only when I began to learn that my boyhood freedom was an illusion. Illusion means something that appears to be real, but it is not. So, slowly and gradually, when he started growing up as a man, he realized that as a child, what he thought he had all the freedom was actually a kind of illusion. That means it was not real. It was fake. Okay? When I discovered as a young man that my freedom had already been taken from me, that means he came to know that he was not free, he was under the control or he was a slave of the Britishers. That means whatever the Britishers told, he had to strictly follow, and if he didn't follow, then he would be beaten up or he would be even put behind the jails or the bars. Okay? Okay, fine. That I began to hunger for it. So it was the time when he realized that his life is not free at all or not totally free. At that time, he got the hunger for freedom. He felt that he should fight for his country and his people right, so that they can even enjoy their life with freedom. At first, as a student, I wanted freedom only for myself. The transitory freedoms of being able to stay out at night, transitory means not permanent. That means when we are child, we demand for small things, right? If we don't, if we are not allowed to go out at late at night, then we say, please, I want to go out with my friends, I want to go for a movie. So our demands and the needs are very small, which are not permanent, right? So he is saying the transitory freedoms, that means small freedoms which were not permanent or which he wanted always. So the transitory freedoms of being able to stay out at night, read what I pleased and go where I choose. Later as a man, young man in Johannesburg, I yearned for the basic and honorable freedoms of achieving my potential. Yearn means to feel a strong desire or wish for something. So what he is saying that when he became a young man in Johannesburg, he desired or he wished for the basic and honorable freedoms, because when he was grown up, he knew that he was not totally free and he was totally under the control of the Britishers. That what the Britishers said they had to do and they had to follow the instructions, they could not do anything on their own. Okay? Of earning my keep, of marrying and having a family, the freedom not to be obstructed in a lawful way. Okay? So what he is saying, I yearned for the basic and honorable freedoms of achieving my potential, of earning my keep, of marrying and having a family, the freedom not to be obstructed in a lawful life. That means all these things were basic, and even for these basic things also he had to fight, right? They did not even have the basic freedom or the commonest freedom which they should get, okay? But then I slowly saw that not only was I not free, that means he realized that he was not the only person who did not have the freedom, but my brothers and sisters were not free. I saw that it was not just my freedom that was curtailed. Curtailed means reduced or taken away. But the freedom of everyone who looked like I did. That means he was a black skinned person. So he is saying that even the other people who are of the black skin, even their freedom was curtailed. That means their freedom was also taken away by the Britishers. That is when I joined the African National Congress, and that is when the hunger for my own freedom became the greater hunger for the freedom of my people. That means after joining the African National Congress and after becoming mature or after getting the understanding that not only his freedom was taken away, but the freedom of all the black skinned people who were looking like him, all of their freedom was taken away by the Britishers. So at that time he realized that this is wrong. It was this desire for the freedom of my people to live their lives with dignity and self-respect that animated my life. Animated means changed his life. His life became totally lively. That means now he had some goals in his life. He had some targets that he wants to free his people from the Britishers, right? So his life had become lively, right? Animated means filled with life, right? So before that he did not have any kind of clear objective or goal, okay? That transformed a frightened young man into a bold one, and due to this objective or goal, Nelson Mandela had become very bold. That means he had become very, very strong. Right? Before, he was a matured person. He was frightened of everything. But now he had become very bold. That drove a law-abiding attorney. Attorney means a lawyer, right? Who is the follower of law. So what he is saying? That drove a law-abiding attorney to become a criminal. That means a person who was an attorney, who was a person who always used to follow the law, now he had become a criminal. Criminal here means a person who is not following any kind of law or who is not following any kind of instructions, right, of the law. That turned a family loving husband into a man without a home. That means he was always out of his house or home, fighting for his own nation, fighting for his own people, that is the people of South Africa. That forced a life loving man to live like a monk. So we all know that monk are the people who don't have any kind of desire for their own self, right? They always live for the society. I am no more virtuous. Virtuous means morally good behavior or character or self-sacrificing than the next man. But I found that I could not even enjoy the poor and limited freedom. That means first he was following the rules and regulations what the Britishers had formed. Now he is not following any kind of rules and regulations because he has realized that their people, that is the black skin people, are not given even the smallest or the little freedom which is their right. Right, we'll move further. I was allowed when I knew my people were not free. Freedom is indivisible. Indivisible means impossible to divide or separate. So what he is saying, that freedom is indivisible. The chains on anyone of my people were the chains on all of them. The chains on all of my people were the chains on me. So what Nelson Mandela is trying to say, that the chains on anyone of my people, that means any of the black skin people, were not given the freedom, that means the freedom of all the people was taken away. And the chains on all of my people were the chains on me. That means he is trying to say that if even a single person or even a single black skin person is not given the freedom, that means he thinks that even his freedom is also taken away. That means he is trying to say that now he wants the freedom of each and every individual, even a single person who is the native of South Africa, who is a black skin person, should get the freedom. Okay, I knew that the oppressor must be liberated just as surely as the oppressed. Now we need to understand the meaning of oppressor and oppressed. Oppress, I have already explained you, to treat in a cruel or unfair way. Oppressor means a person or a group that uses the power in a cruel or unjust way. And oppressed means a person who is treated in a cruel or unfair way. A person whose opportunities and freedoms are taken away. Okay, so now we'll read the paragraph. I knew that the oppressor, that means a person who is doing the cruelty, must be liberated just as surely as the oppressed. Okay, a man who takes away another man's freedom is a prisoner of hatred. He is locked behind the bars of prejudice. Prejudice means biasness and narrow-mindedness. I am not truly free if I am taking away someone else's freedom, just as surely as I am not free when my freedom is taken from me. The oppressed and the oppressor alike are robbed to their humanity. That means he's trying to explain it to us, that if we take away the freedom of other people, then even our own freedom is taken away. Right? So students, that's it for today. I end my lecture over here. And we complete our second chapter over here. Thank you so much everyone for watching my video. Please keep watching my video. And if you like my videos, please subscribe my channel. Also like and share my videos as much as possible. Till then, stay healthy and stay safe. Thank you everyone.